to my channel Avanti Morocha. Today I'm going to show you how to use the new feature in Cricut Design Space, Offset. It is important to mention that this new feature is only available in the desktop application. Now, let's begin. You will find the Offset tool in the editor bar. You need to select an image or text to activate it. If you don't see this tool for some reason, it could be that you haven't updated the firmware. While the firmware should update automatically, if it is out of date, go to the menu and update the firmware manually. Another reason could be that you are using a computer with a system that doesn't support this feature. This notice is from the Cricut site. The offset feature is supported on systems running Windows 10 64-bit only and higher, and macOS 10.15 and higher. Additionally, make sure canvas style is set to new. Go to the menu, click on settings, and make sure the canvas style is set to new. Now I'm going to show you some examples using this feature. It is important to mention that offset is still beta, which means Cricut is still improving this tool. First, I'm going to show you how to use this feature when using shapes and images. Here I have a shape with a single layer. Here I have three shapes with three layers. And here I have a Cricut Access image with three layers. I will select this shape. As you can see, it is a single layer. Go to offset, move the slider. Here you can visualize the changes. If you prefer, you can use a specific measure. Select the kind of corners, rounded or square. Click on apply and press attention to the changes in the layer panel. As you can see, there is a new layer. I will change the fill color. Now I will select the shapes. As you can see, I selected three layers. Go to offset, move the slider. I will use the square corners. When you are using more than one layer or text, you will find this option, well, offset. Based on the project you are making, you may want to keep it checked or unchecked. Click on apply and press attention to the layer panel. As you can see, there is a new layer. I will change the fill color. I will move it so you can see it is welded. Click on undo to put it back in place. Now I'll be using this Cricut Access image. It has three layers. Go to offset, move the slider. I'm going to use rounded corners. Click on apply. I will change the fill color of the new layer. If you wonder what kind of projects you can make using this feature, here are a couple. You can use it to cut iron on in layers. I don't recommend more than three layers. You can also use it for adhesive vinyl or to make stickers. If you want to make stickers, make sure you select the layers and click on flatten. This way, this layer becomes a print then cut layer. The same with this one, select the layers and click on flatten. Now it's a print then cut layer. Now I'm going to show you the offset feature when using your own images or images you bought online. Go to upload. Here I have some images that I uploaded. I will use this photo from my dog. It is a JPEG image. Click on insert. Now I will insert a circle. I will place it over my dog photo. Now select both layers and click on slice. I will delete the layers that I don't need. Select this layer, go to offset, move the slider, and click on apply. I will change the fill color. Select both layers and click on flatten. Now I have a sticker that I made with my dog photo. If you want the offset to go around the image, I recommend using PNG or SVG format. Again, go to upload, and this time I will select a PNG image. Insert image. This image has a transparent background, which means the offset will go around the image. Go to offset, move the slider, click on apply. I will change the fill color of the new layer. And here you can see that the offset went around the image. Now I will use an SVG image, go to upload. I will select this SVG image. This kind of image usually comes with the layers create. Click on insert. As you can see, this image has three layers. I'm going to modify the dimensions. Go to offset. Move the slider. I will select the square corners. Click on apply. Finally, I will change the fill color. If you want to make stickers with them, select the layers and click on flatten. Same here, select the layers and click on flatten. Now I will show you how offset works when using text. I will use this script and serif fonts. I will start with this one. I will change the letter space. I know minus 0.5 works well with this font. Now go to offset, move the slider. I will use rounded corners, click on apply. I will change the fill color. You can use this design to make t-shirts, cake toppers, stickers, and more. If you want to cut it into two pieces, don't forget to weld the text layer. Select the layer and click on weld. This way, this layer is cut as a single piece. Now I'm going to use this font. Go to offset, move the slider. I will use the square corners, click on apply. I will change the fill color. This is totally up to you, but I'm not too fond of this opening. Make sure you are selecting the shadow layer and click on contour. And I'm going to hide the opening. I hope these examples help you to understand how offset works. The best way to learn is to practice. I hope you like this video and you find it informative. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. If you are interested in any of these Cricut machines, I'm going to share the links where you can buy them in the info box below the video. If you are new to my channel and you like what you see, hit the subscription button, tap the notification bell so you get informed every time I release a new video. Don't forget to visit my blog, follow me on my social media, like this video, and share it with your loved ones. See you soon. Ciao, ciao.